Hey everybody! Gonna start doing some more work here on the Alienware mod. I've been switching back and forth between Twitch and YouTube, so if you want to go see what else I've done also on this mod, you can go to our YouTube channel. Just go in to YouTube and search for Modders Inc. and you'll see us. It's actually like youtube.com/c/Modders Inc. 1. You can actually see it on the screen there. You can check it out. Go there, see what the last ones or one or two that I think I've done over there. Come back to here. So what I'm gonna do tonight is I've been working on the side panels. I made some raised panels. This is actually it's a balsa foam. It's really light. Glued some pieces together. Had to make the shape. As you can see, it's not completely flat. It has to match the side panel. I've got some other pieces coming along. I'm gonna do some other stuff. But what I want to do now is try to start getting the design onto this so I can start carving it out. So I can get the hieroglyphics on here. So what I'm going to do on this side is I'm going to put the Alienware head and then 20 into it, which is for the 20th anniversary, and then I'm going to add a whole bunch of other stuff. What I did was go online, you know, and get some ideas on some hieroglyphics and things that they've seen, like in some of the drawings they've always had, you know, like spaceships and aliens and some of this other stuff. So I grabbed a few of those off the internet so I can kind of give me an idea of how it looks, see how it looks cracked and stuff like that, so that I can get into the design. So what I really want to do is I want to get that. This side, I think I'm going to make it fairly large because I want to make sure that it stands out because it's supposed to be for Alienware and it's supposed to be the 20th anniversary. So I've already measured this out. Of how long this is and how wide it is, and I got my center point, and I already did that on the side panel, and now I'm just going to kind of match it up to the two points. Get fairly close to where I want it, see if I can get a couple pieces of tape, maybe just to hold it a little bit. I don't have to sit there and try and hold it down. It doesn't have to do anything except just stay there so I can take my pencil. Just kind of make a rough outline. Because this stuff is, if you just barely push on it, it makes a groove into it pretty well. So I should be able to see where I want to make my grooves at. So I'm going to take the pencil, set, push down a little bit around the edges where I want it. This and this idea and this design is that it doesn't have to be 110%. You know, it's gotta look like it was from 1,000 years ago or however long ago it might have been. So if the numbers aren't quite right or it's not dug out just right, you know, it was dug out of, you know, chiseled out and dug out of, you know, the stone and stuff for thousands of years ago, little hammers and rocks or whatever they use. But it's got to look cool and neat so that it looks like, you know, maybe an alien made it. But again, it can be somewhat rough in texture, but we're really looking to do. Like I said, I can feel it when I'm pressing down on it, that I can feel it actually distorting the foam underneath, so it should have a pretty good outline of what I'm trying to get. I'm putting that little mark on there so that I know where I've gone around, because the pencil on the black line is just not showing up, so I want to know where I started and finished. Oh yeah, so I know you can't see it, but I can definitely see where it is imprinted on here. So I think what I'm going to do is I am just going to go ahead, take the pencil, kind of roughly outline where it's at, so I can kind of get an idea without having to struggle about where the shape is. And so when I start carving it out, I can see what I'm doing here. So what I really want to do is trying to get this shape, and then I can start going back and look at some of the other stuff that I've got, like some of these designs. You see, like, what they have in common, like, you notice they have all the lines that go across, and they've always got them kind of blocked off a little bit. So where I know where this is at, I can start now making a shape around it. So what I think I'm going to do is actually probably box this around. think I like that. I think, though, what I'm going to do is I'm trying to figure out if I want to I think what I'm going to end up doing is this part here, like the eyes, this part out here. I think I'm going to make that recess, make the head, that the head stands out and the numbers stand out in this section. And then I think the other pieces I'm going to actually carve into. So I kind of got an idea about what I want to do with the eyes. So I gotta think about it. But either way though, I do think that I'm going to continue with like another line on the outside of this. So even if I go down, I think I want another outline of this. So I think I'm gonna go probably like 5 millimeters. So yeah, I like that. That's a good start. I mean, even though it's just like random patterns and stuff like that to us, it's probably, it tells us some kind of a story, so I need to kind of look at it and put certain things in there to make it look good. I mean, I could just go in there and just put stuff in and go, oh yeah, that looks great. But I want to try and get some stuff in there to look like it should be together, or maybe I can do some hidden messages actually in this thing. But I do think that I'm going to continue this line across. And then do some vertical ones this way. Kind of get this shape. See how it is here? It's got some vertical stuff that's going across the bottom here, and then stuff that's going up and down. And I think I'm going to do that. Just trying to figure out how big do I want to make some of these stuff. I'm almost thinking to use this center line that I have, or I put the pieces together, I might just end up using that as a center line there, and then going out. So that would put it about 2 3/4-ish. Yeah, I think so. That'll go in again with this. These lines will kind of line up here. Yeah, I think I'm gonna like that design. I'm gonna have to take this. Separate it again here. Again, another, these are, I'm making, so these will all be a grooved line. These will all be a groove. Like I said, what's kind of cool is that even though, you know, like, that's not straight, it doesn't have to be exactly straight, but probably a little straighter than what I did there. I think I was standing off a little bit. Yeah, that'll be much better this way. So I think what I'm gonna end up doing is just kind of tagging that a little bit. I think actually what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna scribe this one a little bit so I know which one's which. So I've got this tool, it's actually for clay, and it's got, where it's a sharp point on the side, it's like, almost like a razor on each side, and you can cut it sharp point. And then this is kind of scooped out, again, comes down fairly sharp, it's got sharp edges on the side. I'm gonna use this for like I've already done here, is making a V shape cut out of the foam. See, that comes out of there pretty dang easy. Excuse the vacuum. Uh-oh. I think my shop back just went to poots. Yeah. Yeah, that kind of sucks, it did. Well, I've only had that shop back for, I don't know, 4 or 5 years, so guessing it's about time to get a new one anyway. So what I'm gonna do is, then I'm just gonna take my brush and just clean it out. Guess I know where I'll be going tomorrow. Shop back time. Yeah, that kind of sucks. Switch pretty much is gone on that. So, I could take it apart, probably fix it. Alright, since I screwed up the other lines, now I know what lines I got there. I know what I want to do. So I'm going to continue on with some of the drawings here. I'm putting in some of the designs that they have that I can see. So I think... like right here. Man, let's see. Let me draw it out first. Maybe I'll come up with something first before I draw it on there. Might be like stick figure-ish. But I can... kind of take what they've drawn on there, kind of stick figure-ish, but I can fill it in, you know, so I can make this. A little bigger, like that. Make it like that. Something like that. Or maybe something a little more helmet looking or something, you know? Maybe something like that. I can put maybe one on this side and one on the other side. Maybe a little less in the back. Yeah. Shoulder, maybe shorter in the arm, maybe. Yeah, I think I like that one. So yeah, not so bad. I mean, all I need is a rough sketch, and then I can just go back and I can carve them out the way I want them. So that's what I'm going to end up doing here, is just, you know, doing most of this just in a rough sketches. Picking out some of the items I think looks kind of cool here, and use those. Not as good. Probably. Yeah, I think I like that. Using this black pen a little better so I can kind of see what I'm doing also. And then I think maybe you guys can see a little better too. Must be some kind of a bird, it looks like. what that's supposed to be. Looks like some kind of, almost looks like some type of utensils or tools. That kind of design, see? Not looking too bad, right? I hope you're saying yes. But this is what I'm going with. There's a snail, this is like snail looking thing. I think I'm gonna put that down here. Hope I'm not drawing any bad words or something. Yeah, so what do you guys think? Think it looks alright? I think it's looking pretty good. You know, I don't want to get a... I want to get enough detail, but I want to don't get it like all overloaded with a bunch of detail either. I think I'm gonna leave this open so see if I get an idea or something to add some maybe something else in there. You know, I'm trying to figure out, you know, little things that maybe I can hide and into there. You know, maybe I can put the website name in here somewhere, or you know, something that I would recognize and know why I put it in there. You know, maybe some different shapes or something weird, something different. You know, like I just saw a weird shape just caught my eye looking over here. Actually, not actually a weird shape. Looks like a musical note that's on this thing. That nicely fills up that part of the page, though. Part of the stone. Well, it almost acts like it might even mean something with all this stuff in here. Thing I do notice though, they sure do, they use a lot of birds in these things. yeah, I think that's looking pretty good. I think I'm going to maybe carve a couple of pieces out here just to see how it's going to look. Grab a trash can and my brush so I can knock it in there since my shop back decided to take a dump. So yeah, that's not so bad. Looks like a Kirby. Yeah, that's pretty good, I think. definitely looking like some kind of a carving. That's a quick piece of there. So what I'm going to end up doing is, you know, doing all the rest of it like this. You know, but what's cool and what's kind of cool is that I can, you know, adjust it as I go. Like, ooh, I don't like that, or ooh, there's a nick out of it. It actually gives it more character to it and gives it that really a more authentic look. And, what I'm trying to achieve, you know, I can go back and make these grooves a lot bigger, a lot deeper, to really give it that character and that look, like it's been chiseled out of the stone. And the drawings were just outlines, so I mean, if I'm not 100% on them, it's not a real big deal. Or if it comes out exactly how I drew it on there, it's for the guidelines of just the design. And then, you know, as I'm doing it here, if I want to, you know, not do one line or want to make the line a little different shape or something, I get the total freedom to do that, because who's going to tell me that it's wrong? So I think I'm going to do one more here. I think I'll do this. See, what was kind of weird is that shape was not like an eye, but more maybe like an eagle eye or something. It had that kind of a shape where it was like that. But I'm almost wondering if that's too busy here. So I got quite a few pieces here. think I'm going to come back to that one. I'm still trying to decide on that one. I'm looking at it, and the design, it almost be, it might be a little too busy. Yeah, I think I'm going to come back on that one. I'm not liking it. It looks too crowded. I think I'm going to do one of these guys, though. Not too sure about the shape of the head, though. But that's the way they show it in the drawings. It's more like maybe like a headdress or something. But I think I'm gonna round it up a little more. yet, but in the pictures it shows that. Body and the head are recessed. Yeah, that gives it some, that actually gives it some pretty good depth. Yeah, that's cool. So I think that what I'm going to end up doing is doing the same thing here. Like I said, is leaving the actual head and the numbers raised up. Excuse me. Thank you. And I'll do the same thing on this side. I think I'm getting a pretty good feel of it, getting how I'm wanting to look at it. I think how I'm going to do, I think I'm definitely going to readjust this side, though. I think it's just too crowded with some stuff. So I think I might bring... There's actually two eyes here, but you know, it shows it like that in one of the pictures. So it's got to mean something. But I think I'm going to switch this up a little bit over here. So I'm going to leave that one as it is. Rest of it, I kind of like the way it lays out. So I'm going to put something across here. And then, not sure yet. I can find some cool pictures or something else that I've got printed out, maybe put in there. I mean, one of the cool things here that I kind of like is that, might even do that. That actually would be kind of cool. Now that I'm thinking about it, I think I just might just do that. This size. Then carve it out kind of deep and then just make like rays coming off of it. And then the picture shows something here. See how that goes, but yeah, I kind of like that. Like, it looks kind of cool. Like, it's gonna shine it down on top of this part. So, like I said, I'm gonna redo this. I kind of like the way this looks. Like here, I think I'm gonna add something right here though. Don't know yet. Everything else, I kind of liken the way it's looking. I think I'm going to space this out a little more, though. I think these couple ones are, I like what's there, but I think it's a little too close. I kind of like the shape of that. The lines, it's kind of good. This will take up that space on this side, I think. Might add something here, but overall, I think it looks pretty good. And I think I've had enough for tonight out in the shop, so gotta get cleaned up. I guess it looks like I gotta go get a little shop vac tomorrow after work. But I am liking the progress. Should be getting this one, and I'm also gonna have a second panel. So I forget I gotta do two of these. So this is stuff that I put on there to fill in the gaps, and I'm gonna sand it down and get it to the shape I want. And that would go on the other side panel. And we'll be doing some other shaping and some other designs. And I've got some stuff that I want to try and do. I shouldn't say try and do. I'm going to have to do, because that's part of the ideas and thoughts that I have that I really need to make it work. And it's probably going to take a little bit of thought. I don't know if I can muster up that much brain power, but we'll definitely see what I can do. Maybe I might go into the chat and talk to the clan and say, "Gag is getting the ideas," or maybe just talk. You know, sometimes it's just great to just sit there and talk with the guys. We do a lot of hard work over at Modders Inc. We got a lot of great guys that'll do wonderful hardware reviews. I mean, those guys are just amazing at what they do on that stuff. And I thank them for every minute and every second that they spend doing that. Allows me to get away from that a little bit more and do what I really like to enjoy is, you know, doing this creative stuff, doing the case myself. I'm an artistic type of person, and, you know, this is really neat. I'm getting to carve stuff and make stuff and then make it so that other people like it. And, well, hopefully the other people like it. And I get to have a good time at it, and I get to share what I like. So, again, you know, thanks for watching. Probably, maybe tomorrow night. Depends on, how late I have to stay at work, and if I stop by Home Depot to get one of those little Stingray vacuums, which I probably should have bought about a year ago. This switch had been going in and out on this one. But, you know, like everything else, so it'll last. Well, it decided, I guess, today was its last day. Like I said, maybe I'll try and get out in the shop again on tomorrow. If I'm not in the shop tomorrow, definitely probably Wednesday night, and then I'm off a couple of days. So I'll be definitely out here in the shop working over the weekend, you know, Thursday, Friday, my weekend, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. Got a lot to do to get done. So we can get this thing getting going, and a lot of stuff has to go back together. I definitely got to get this stuff carved out, get it to the way I want it, Got a few things that looks, that's got to come in that I've ordered. Hopefully that'll all get here and you'll see the final product sometime this month. It's supposed to be the middle of this month, I do believe, like around the, 13th, 14th, 15th, 18th, somewhere around in there. I'll have to look at the rules or when they actually want this stuff. But again, I hope you guys can see it, see what I've been doing. I mean, if I turn it around, you'd probably get a couple of good angles at it. You can see the shadows. I think it's starting to come out good. Some of this stuff I'll probably go a little deeper with, but I'm enjoying it. Thanks for watching. I know I'm rambling, but again, thanks for watching. Go to Modders Inc. You can just search for Modders Inc. in Google or Yahoo or Bing or whatever. Or you can just go to modders-inc.com. Or you can just type it all in as one word, moddersinc.com. It'll go to the same places. You can find us also on Facebook that way. You can find us on Twitter that way, Pinterest. I mean, all the places that you can think of, that's what we have. Friend us, like us, subscribe to us. Do all that social stuff that I don't do. Make sure you do it. And thanks again for watching. Hey, so how was the video? You liked it? I know I did. So, you know, go ahead and subscribe. I mean, it's not that bad. I mean, it's one click. You know, I mean, you've clicked on worse things before.